The simple lesson with sample rate is that more is better. But did you know that the method of achieving that high sample rate can actually distort your signal and throw off your measurements? Hi, I'm Erin East with Keysight. This episode of Exposing Signal Integrity Myths is all about sample rate. We all know sample rate is one of the banner specifications of an oscilloscope. We've been taught that the higher the sample rate, the better the measurement will be. Don't get me wrong, this still holds completely true. However, there's something to be wary of. Do you know exactly how your oscilloscope is achieving those high sample rates? That can make a huge difference in your measurements. Before we dive into that, let's take a step back. Why do we even care about sample rate? Modern oscilloscopes convert your analog signal input into a digital signal so that you can see it on the display. The conversion works by taking data points or samples of your analog signal and using those points to reconstruct the waveform digitally. You can see the path that your signal takes through the oscilloscope in this animation. Once your signal reaches the front end of the scope, the sampler will collect data points. Those data points will feed into the analog to digital converter, or ADC, where they're converted to digital values. They're stored in memory and eventually processed and displayed on the screen. Simply put, the sample rate is just the rate at which the sampler collects samples. The sample rate is measured in samples per second. This rate ultimately affects the signal that you see on screen. In a well-designed oscilloscope, samples will occur at a consistent rate with no variation. We'll learn about why that's important in a little bit. And it's important to remember that memory and sample rate are closely linked. As you increase the time base, more of your waveform will display. This means that more memory is being used to store that long time span of data points. Well, this will effectively decrease the sample rate because the oscilloscope can only store a certain number of samples in memory. When you adjust the time base, notice how it changes the sample rate automatically. Too low of a sample rate makes your signal look choppy, causes you to miss some signal detail, and skews your measurements. Always be sure to use the correct scaling for the analysis you're trying to perform. So, what does all of this mean to your measurements? Let's take a look at what a signal looks like with a high sample rate versus a low sample rate. You can see with the high sample rate of 20 gigasamples per second, we see a nice smooth representation of our signal and can make accurate measurements on it. With a low sample rate of 20 megasamples per second, we can see that the signal looks distorted because there are not enough samples available to correctly interpolate the waveform. If you were to perform a peak-to-peak measurement on this, your results would be completely inaccurate. Additionally, if your sample rate isn't high enough, you'll miss signal detail, glitches, or errors because elements can occur between collected samples. Since glitches and spurs can mean the difference between a device functioning correctly or not, it's critical to detect them in the design phase. Undersampling could easily cause you to think that your signal is clean, when in fact it has several issues. So the key point here is that the higher the sample rate, the higher the resolution of the trace. This will allow you to make more accurate measurements of your signal and catch any errors that may exist. To learn how to determine what sample rate is adequate for your signal, check out the white paper, Everything You Need to Know About Sample Rate, at the link on screen or in the description. In that white paper, you can also learn about some of the different acquisition modes that can be used to analyze your samples in different ways. Now, onto the big problem. I mentioned that high sample rates are ideal, but you have to be wary of the method that's being used to achieve that high sample rate. This method can make or break your measurements, quite literally. The problem I'm referring to is called interleaved distortion. Some oscilloscopes can reach incredibly high sample rates, like 40 gigasamples per second and higher. However, to achieve these rates, you have to use two or more ADCs, synchronized with clock phase delays in a one fires then the other pattern. This is a very common practice and it effectively doubles the sample rate. At a high level, this technique seems useful. After all, the faster the sample rate, the higher the resolution. However, there's a catch. If you think about the Nyquist theorem, it states that the samples must be equally spaced in time to produce an accurate trace. While this is relatively easy to do with a single ADC, it's much more difficult to get the phase delay clocks of multiple ADCs perfectly synchronized. To achieve this, the synchronized ADCs must have the same vertical gain, offset, and frequency response. If these interleaving requirements are not satisfied, the phase delay clocks will not be aligned, causing inconsistent spacing between samples like you see here. You can see how the misaligned clocks cause the samples to be collected at varying intervals. The processor in the oscilloscope assumes that all samples are collected at a consistent rate. This means if the samples are collected at uneven intervals, when the waveform is digitally reconstructed, it'll appear distorted. Much like the distorted signal with too low of a sample rate that we saw earlier, any measurements you make on a signal like this will be completely inaccurate. So in this case, the higher sample rate actually produces a less accurate waveform. Typically, a higher sample rate is preferred, but when improper interleaving technology enters the process, it brings enough inaccuracy to negate this method of achieving a faster sample rate. This is especially true when working with extremely high frequency signals, since even the smallest misalignment in clocking has significant effect on the waveform. However, there are many cases where this interleaving is implemented correctly, like with the Keysight S-series oscilloscope we're using today. Interleaving isn't something to be afraid of, just something to be cautious of. There are also some extremely precise oscilloscopes out there, like the Keysight UXR series, that can reach incredibly high sample rates without interleaving ADCs. This will, of course, give you even more accuracy and higher signal integrity. Aside from visually seeing the distortion in the trace on screen, there's also a test you can perform to see if interleaved distortion exists in your oscilloscope and if it's responsible for any inaccuracies. When you see distortion on your signal, you can only guess at whether that distortion is caused by the ADC interleaving or if there's some other reason. Use a fast Fourier transform or an FFT to quickly and easily evaluate the nature of the distortion. With an FFT, you can see the various frequency components of your signal. You should be able to look at the harmonics of your signal, but any irregular spikes found between these harmonics could be identified as harmonic distortion, noise, or interleaved distortion. So looking at this FFT display of a 2.5 gigahertz sine wave at 40 gigasamples per second, the fundamental frequency stands out here, and you can look at the harmonics at consistent intervals. There are no unexpected frequency components between any of the harmonics or fundamental frequency, so this signal is not likely subject to interleaved distortion. Now, on this screenshot you see from another vendor's oscilloscope, an FFT is performed on the same signal using a sample rate of 40 gigasamples per second. There are multiple significant spurs outside the fundamental frequency and harmonics. The largest is at 7.5 gigahertz, which is 10 gigahertz below the fundamental frequency. The next largest is at 12.5 gigahertz, which is 10 gigahertz above the fundamental frequency. The four ADCs in the oscilloscope sample at 10 gigasamples per second. So it's evident that the interleaved ADCs are directly responsible for this distortion. It's not uncommon for scopes with extremely high sample rates to produce distorted signal reconstructions on screen. It's really important to be aware of the possible downsides of faster sample rates and always check for those on any oscilloscope you're using. So in summary, always be cautious when you're working with both low and high sample rates. This is a key specification to monitor when you're making measurements. Remember that the sample rate can automatically change as you adjust the time-based setting. So be sure that you're using the appropriate settings to make the measurements you need to make. The key things to remember about sample rate in your testing are that sample rate refers to the rate at which the oscilloscope can collect data points in samples per second. Too low of a sample rate can cause distortion and skew in your measurements. And lastly, interleaved ADCs will present an impressive sample rate specification. However, if they're not properly synchronized, this method can distort your signal. The sample rate is more than just an internal working of your oscilloscope. It has a profound impact on the trace you see. Sample rate determines whether you see an accurate representation of your signal or a distorted one. As an engineer creating new digital designs in a world of increasingly fast data rates and high precision devices, you don't have any room for unnecessary development delays. don't let your oscilloscope's internal errors affect your measurements. In addition to sample rate, there are a few other key considerations to ensure your oscilloscope gives the highest signal integrity and best measurement accuracy. To learn about the other important aspects of signal integrity, download the ebook, How to Determine Oscilloscope Signal Integrity. Thanks for joining today. Before you head out, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.